Operation Amotekun was established on the 9th of January, year 2020, by the six state governors of the southwestern state, with Ekiti being one of the front runners of the scheme. As early as the 16th of March that same year, the state's governor, Kayode Fayemi, had already signed the Amotekun bill into law.
It is my pleasure to welcome you to this very important occasion of the inauguration of the Ekiti State Security Network Agency, Amotekun Corps. Today is significant in our history as a state and a people, as we inaugurate the security agency codenamed Amotekun. I congratulate the management and graduating personnel of Amotekun.
The incessant invasion of the Southwest by criminal elements from within and outside the region led to calls for immediate and practical steps towards finding lasting solutions to the problem. This was when the idea of Amotekun was conceived, as it fitted the idea of an outfit with zero tolerance to criminality. To the joy of many Ekiti residents, the Operation Amotekun was inaugurated in the state on the 19th of October 2020.
Ekiti State is no longer safe for criminals, and they should flee immediately. We can no longer tolerate indiscipline and threats to our existence as the people in this state.
His Royal Majesty Oba Adebanji Ajibade Alabi Afontade I, the Alawe of Ilawe Ekiti, has this to say about the history and importance of the Amotekun cause in his kingdom and Ekiti at large.
His Royal Majesty of Adebanji Ajibade Alabi Afontade I, the Alawe of Ilawe Ekiti. It's my pleasure to comment on the emergence and the activities of Amotekun for the past 1 year. The concept of Amotekun came into being in 2019. This was actually a sequel to the upsurge in security challenges that pervaded the entire country at that time. The Southwest was not left out of the security problems, the challenges, cases of kidnapping, robbery, attacks, farmers, herders, clashes here and there. And sequel to this, as a way of addressing this menace of insecurity, the Southwestern states governors met, they discovered the need to set up a security service to take care of the security needs of the Southwest region of the country. And that was how the concept of Amotekun came into being in 2019. When the concept came into being, the inauguration, formal inauguration of Amotekun took place in Ibadan on 9th of January 2020. On 9th of January 2020 at Ibadan, I was there. Alari of Ekiti was there too. And the Oni of Ife was at Ibadan. During the time Amotekun was brought into life, during the launching ceremony, and all the governors of the southwestern region were there to participate in the exercise. And the governor spoke extensively about the reasons for the concept of Amotekun. We as traditional rulers too corroborated it, that Amotekun will help in those memorial in ameliorating the security challenges that had bedeviled the states in the Southwest then. That actually gave birth to Amotekun on the 9th of January, year 2020. But to our greatest consternation, surprise, and shock, shortly after the inauguration of Amotekun in Ibadan, there were resistance here and there. Resistance came from several angles, from the federal government, from some other regional governments against Amotekun, thinking that it was ill-motivated. But we are highly delighted that we stood our ground. As traditional rulers, we spoke vehemently in support of Amotekun, and we made them realize the need for Amotekun as our own way of addressing the security challenges that had bedeviled our own region, just like other parts of the country. The governors of the Southwest stood their ground. We traditional rulers, we stood our ground. I remember speaking vociferously in support of Amotekun, and at the end of the day, the federal government was able to acquiesce, and they had no option than to allow Amotekun to be. The various state governments enacted laws supporting Amotekun, set up Amotekun, and they had to launch Amotekun separately in the various states of the Southwest. I recall our own in Ekiti State. I was the chairman of the Traditional Council then. That was 19th of October. We did our own launching in a grand style. And since the establishment and the launching of Amotekun in Ekiti State, it has been a wonderful security outfit. It has become the signature of all lives. We are all dependent on Amotekun, largely for the security of Ekiti State. Traditional rulers, whenever we had problems, we were always beckoning on Amotekun to come to the rescue, and they have lived up to expectation for this past 1 year. They deserve great commendation. The leadership should be commended, the personnel should be commended for their effective and professional conduct for this past 1 year. We've not heard any negative report, we've not had any case of molestation, harassment, intimidation of the citizenry. They have been exceptionally professional. It is the only thing now in the Ekiti State, whenever we had any security challenge, either in our forest or farms or anywhere, we beckon on Amotekun. I take Kilawe, my kingdom, for example. I've had calls to beckon on Amotekun to intervene in various cases of a kidnap here and there, and they've actually lived up to expectation. Recently, we don't make noise about some of these things. Recently, we beckoned on Amotekun when some people were trying to create a kidnapping colony somewhere on our land here, in our forest. We were able to root the criminals out of the place. We really, really appreciate Amotekun. And as traditional rulers, we will continue to support the initiative of government on Amotekun. We will continue to back Amotekun in all our towns and ensure the success of the security network.
Traditionally, humankind has always been afraid of what they do not understand. Yeah, sometimes people throw out revolutionary ideas because people either do not understand it or are not willing to understand it. But be away, Yoruba say so. Ti alagbara ko ni o nberu. But ti alagbara, won ni ti alagbara ba ti konka eru, eru ga ma ba eru. So as you go to the full Yoruba, Kaderuba Eru,
help my colleagues and I to fashion a way that we can utilize to complement the work of our mainstream security agencies that are quite overstretched in their effort to arrest the menace that afflicted not just our zone, but the entire country at the time. But having been a relatively peaceful zone that had now started witnessing this problem, our people became extremely agitated. So from 6 months ago, when we held our initial summit here in Ibadan, I am pleased that this idea, whose time has come, has also been embraced by the leadership of our security agencies. Because the Inspector General of Police, Muhammad Adamu, had since gone ahead to announce the police's commitment to community policing strategy. And the Western Nigeria Security Network, Amotekun, is nothing but a community policing response to a problem that our people would like to see the back of.
Just as the people have said, it has been a successful year of operations for the Amotekun cause in Ekiti State. They are closer to the grassroots, and that strategy seems to be helping in fighting crime. The Ekiti State Amotekun commander, Brigadier General Joe Komolafe, has one or two things to tell us about the operations.
First of all, our people prefer to talk to us rather than talking to the police because we are closer to the grassroots than the police or other military organization. Then two, balancing. One of the principles of war is cooperation. So if it's a principle that I've been tested for years, and I'm a general, I should be able to apply that principle in managing the security situation in the state. So I have excellent relationship and working and outside the uniform relationship with all the other security agencies. 1 year old next week, God willing. And we have tested what I would call pilot scheme. After the pilot scheme, We now know the areas of our weaknesses, our strength, then and our opportunity, which they call SWOT. So, analyze it, become SWOTer, do that. We now know what is our deficiency in terms of men, material, equipment, so on and so forth. So after the analysis, we can now project whether we need to recruit yearly or by, 2 years in terms of so on and so forth.
Yes,
then what's the number of people we want to recruit? But what I want to let you know is that the Nigerian police, the Nigerian army and police, they are the oldest security organizations in this culture.
Yes,
up to tomorrow, they still carry out recruitment. That means we cannot fill our vacancies once a day.
True.
And some people, that's the area, I think I have issues with some guys out there. They thought that we should just bring everybody. Even if you bring everybody, you still need more people later. So why don't you be gradually, when we finish with this pilot scheme, I will bring the next set. This pilot scheme will be part of it to train the other people in terms of native intelligence. Even have 2 or 3 royal fathers actually accepted to even, they gave us offices in their local government areas, even innovated a place for us. And they assist with local intelligence. And I have direct contact with all of them. And I think I have occasions to address them with their meeting. And they gave me some promises. And part of the promises, I have seen them coming to life. Yes, they should. When it comes to we carrying automatic weapons, the law of the Federation does not allow it. So, but only edited Gumbanli, Puma Arochu, Ocean Rearaye, Ben Rearaon. The civil defense started like this. They were never allowed, in fact, they were voluntary, the organization. It was a voluntary organization in Nigeria before, fashioned after other international civil defenses where they are used during war. Bomber alert system, material duty, so on and so forth. And so later on, they were asked to start protecting our pipelines. And with bare hands, just the way we are protecting the communities with bare hands now. But later, something happened. Today, civil defense carries automatic weapons. So that's why I made that program. If masquerade is pursuing you, just endure for some time. Because as the man is, as you are getting tired, the spirit also is getting tired. One day, Governor Kredolu of Ondo State said so, say, this is what we have told these people. And they said, no. A time is coming. Why another government will be there? And they will listen to people and change their mind. So let us endure. However, when we are doing that, they should try also, we are not using, only a few weapons were automatic when before the Creed War. But again, we still have some of our native powers that we can use. Then when it comes to technology equipment, one of such is the drones, so that we can actually see, not the local one these photographers are using. Yes, they have cameras, they can do it, they can't do the type of job we want. It's something that we should be able to sit down, and if crime is being committed somewhere, we'll send the drone up, they'll be able to tell us, even if they are going, the drone should be able to the foliages,
yes,
operate the foliages and see human beings there with the resolution. And unfortunately, it's not something you go to Ojaoba and buy and collect your change and go home. When that machine comes, we should be able to sleep at least one of our eyes closed, because if you kidnap anybody as we are going in the bush, I will sit down in my office in Amotekun and be watching you, and I will direct my men on how to catch you like snakes.
Diewi of Ado Ekiti, His Royal Majesty Oba Rufus Adeyemo Adejube Aladesanmi III, charged citizens to take security as everyone's business and help the Amotekun achieve their set goals.
But for Amotekun, only God knows what would have been the security situation here in Ekiti. They are now to fill the gap that was led as a result of shortage of police, as I said. But the only problem is that government cannot do everything. When they were in training, I was sending my chiefs to go and supervise and see to their welfare there.
Yes.
And to pray for them. Because their own job is a special job. There are people you expect to go to this forest where you think it's abhorrent strangers that's not conducive to our environment here. You want to send them there. So you can't send them there with empty hand. So as you said, we need to pray for them.
Yes,
and everything to equip them. And the issue of vehicle came up. So I handled the matter, and when I discovered that, yes, the government said it had intention to give them their own voice, but that was no money to buy the vehicle at that time. So first of all, I had to spare one of my pilot cars. And two, one of my subjects, because I told other people, these days when you can't travel, we had meetings, we had rituals, and so meeting. Now I have to narrate the situation back home. Some of them outside the country, and some within the country. So one of them came up with that yes, Kabezi, I remember you mentioned this, the shortage of vehicle. He donated another helos. So that's why we were able to give them two helos for this one. I congratulate the commandant. They've been doing very well, no doubt about it. And they stemmed down the problem. Even when you talk of kidnapping now, the unfortunate thing now is that our indigenous now, yes, they joined. Because there was a case of a prophet. But yes, a pastor of a church. Managing it that he was kidnapped to raise money from the church members. So we would know. And of recent, there was another alarm raised here in Ado Ekiti. When we found out, we discovered too, that within us too, there are some people now masquerading as bandits and kidnappers. So, but for the Amotekun, it would have been easy. So we commend the effort of the commandant and his lieutenant for doing this good job.
The Speaker of the Ekiti State House of Assembly, Fumiyi Afuye, gave insights on the legal framework behind the establishment of the Operation Amotekun and why the corps are not allowed to carry arms. He also commended the corps for their swift response when called upon by citizens in distress.
When the incipients of insecurity became rampant, and it was moving gradually, and it has moved gradually to every nook and cranny of Nigeria. The western region that is made up of six states, they came together, because whether we like it or not, whatever is existing state structure that is existing between us, it's just artificial. We are a region. The governors came together with the outcry of the people and they formed at Amotekun. Amotekun is a resource within what is available within the constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to protect Western region. And of course, any law that the states will make, we have to look at the gray areas within the constitution, that is the constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and see how we can maneuver. Amotekun is a maneuver within the context of the constitution of Nigeria. And of course, you know what the constitution says about carrying arms. It doesn't allow even the states, it's in the exclusive list, it's not in the concurrent list. Well, in fairness to them, they are operating well within the capacity provided by the country, I mean, allowing by the extant laws. They are operating well because you can imagine if there had been no Amotekun, what would have become of insecurity, banditry? I'm not saying the whole place is insulated against all of these things, but it has reduced drastically. Well, let me cite an example. I live in Kere on Ise Road, which used to be the haven of kidnappers. First, the roads have been amended, rehabilitated. And when you are going on that road, you will see at every regular interval, you see the presence of Amotekun. You know, they operate on the roads.
Yes.
And they enter the bush. So, but if you are able to cut the oxygen of allowing them to
pick people
and run into the bush by the presence of the Amotekun,
yes,
that's part of the reasons the whole thing has reduced. But we can go higher, because if the law, the constitution permits the state government to go the whole hog, by the time that happens, if that is allowed, you will see that these people will disappear from our bushes.
Security is everyone's business, not just the government. This was evident as we made a stop at the palace of His Royal Majesty, Oba Adeagbo, the Ore of Mobaland, who gave us more insights on the importance of the Operation Amotekun to his kingdom and Ekiti at large. He then took us on a tour to the standard office, which he allocated to the Amotekun cause, to use as their base. This, according to the monarch, is his own impute to the security of his kingdom.
Amotekun is good. The commander is working well. The boys are very neat, very raw, particularly about neatness. Their boots are well polished.
Yes.
So when they come, we assist them with the little we have for fueling and for servicing. So in a nutshell, Amotekun is proactive, which is good. The only thing that they have one or two challenges, and I know with time, our indefatigable governor will look into it. Another thing we are praying to look into is that border towns, right? We are carrying the APC carrier. We can take work again. Everybody knows it.
Armored personnel carrier.
We are going to the border town.
Yes.
Members of the Ekiti State Amotekun Corps were subjected to 6 weeks intensive training that included exposure to prerequisite knowledge for their role. The Attorney General and Commissioner for Justice, Olawale Fapunda, was personally involved in these training sessions at the Amotekun training camp.
The board and the corps commander adopted the nature of the excellency. For as you know, our governor does not make noise. He doesn't make noise. He's a silent Ashiba. That is why we don't make noise in the Ekiti Amotekun. But the people within the state know that we're really performing. So I give kudos to the corps, to all these, my children, I call them my children, and their commander, and every member of the agency, my board members, for the cooperation they have given me. Now come to challenges. There's nothing that you do that will not have a challenge. We don't have one or two challenges. We have our own challenges. One challenges like money, fund, like logistics, so many things. But there's one thing about us here, and I will say it loud and clear. Security is not government business alone. It was, it's government. hey, government has not provided this. No! Security must be everybody's business.
The Operation Amotekun, in 1 year of existence, has been able to gain the trust of the people, especially the local communities. We can say Ekiti and the southwestern region is safer with the presence of Amotekun cause.